Hi children, have a great day. Today we are going to see the topic. So before going to start a session, let's start with prayer, right? So join your hands, close your eyes. Asato ma satgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrit Tyoma Amritam Gamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Great children, now rub your hands and have a gentle pressure on your eyes and slowly open your eyes. Great. So what is the topic we are discussing about? We are discussing about adaptation in plants and animals. In that, we saw about habitat. What is habitat? The place in which the animals and plants are living is known as habitat. Right? Adaptation. It is the special feature of a plant or animal. With the help of that feature, it will adapt to its surroundings. That feature is called adaptation. Right? So what are the circumstances, what are the situations for which the animals and plants have to adapt? It might be due to climatic conditions, whether the climate may be hot, the climate may be cold, anything, right? And food availability and protection from its predators, right? So how the habitat has been divided? It has been divided as water and land. And the land is further divided into desert, forest, polar region, hills and mountains, and grasslands. Then we saw about animals on land. What are the animal that is named, which is present on land? They are called terrestrial animals. So how the animals in desert will adapt? The desert will be contains hot day during daytime and it will cold during night time, right? So how the camel, lizard and snake will get adapt to these situations? The camel, for preventing the loss of water, it will store the required amount of water in its hump along with its foot. As and when required, it will utilize from there. It can survive for a long time without food and water. Okay, then how the lizard will survive? It will stay in its hole during daytime, while at the night time only it come out of the hole for in search of food. Right. Similarly, how the animals in forest will get adapted? The forest has variety of animals, variety species of more species of animals, right? So it may contain both carnivores, omnivores and herbivores. All types of animals will present in the forest or jungles, right? So for each type of animals, they have been designed with special type of features in order to cope up, that is adapt with its surroundings, right? So these animals may exhibit a mechanism called chemoflagg, which is the changing of color according to its surroundings, which will exhibit by the chameleon, right? When a predator tends to attend the chameleon, it will change its color according to its surrounding so that the predator may get confused and get rid of it. Similarly, porcupine has quills all over its body. As and when a predator attacks it, it starts to shoot out the quills, right? Then how the animals in grasslands will adapt? Grassland have dry and windy temperature. Some fire outbreaks will present. The animals must have to burrow a hole in order to adapt to that fire outbreaks. And it has some special features also. The animals must have to graze in a herd manner so that to avoid or to prevent a loss of water, since there is no trees. There will not be seen much trees, right? They are not dense. Okay. So the grasshopper, for example, how the grasshopper can adapt? It is green in color, as like that of leaf. And also I have long hind leg in order to hop easily, and have short forelimbs in order to hold its foot. Okay, then coming to the polar region, it is very cold. The birds and animals could not cope up with that, so the birds will migrate from one place to another place, and the animals like snake and lizard will hibernate for a long period of time. The polar bear in this region will have thick skin so that it will keep that bear warm. In this way, these animals will adapt to the conditions in polar region. Likewise, animals in water. Animals in water is known as aquatic animals, and animals that is living on land and in water is known as amphibian. So for aquatic animals, especially named organ called gills, which helps them to breathe easily, which will extract the oxygen from the water, and it has fins and tail which makes them to move in different directions. Similarly for amphibian, as it can live both on land and in water, while it is on land it will use lungs for breathing purpose, and while it is in water it will use its skin for its breathing purpose. So these are about animals. Now we are going to see about the plants. The plants that are living on land is called terrestrial plants. Since the desert is very hot, there may be loss of water will be occur. In order to prevent that loss of water, the plants are designed in such a manner that it has thick leaves, so the plants cannot leave its loss its water. Okay, it has deep root in order to search for water. Right, example for desert trees are, desert plants are cactus plant and bubble tree. Next, in forest, the soil is very fertile, so we can see more number of trees there. There they grow in very dense manner, right? So the sun rays will be present in some regions only. Not all the regions receive the same amount of sunlight or sun rays. Right, similar for that, the plants growing in that area will need sunlight. In order to search for the sunlight, the leaves of those plants will grow longer. In this way, these plants will get adapted. Similarly, plants in hills and mountains. Hills and mountains have very snowy conditions. Okay, in order to cope up with that, the trees present there are designed as a canonical form so that the snow can slide away. Right, it has a long needle shaped leaf to prevent the loss of water. These are very dark in color in order to absorb more sunlight for preparing food. These leaves have a wax like coating which can prevent the damage due to snow. In this way, the trees on hills and mountains will get adapted. Right, then plants in grasslands. The grassland has dry condition. Some fire outbreaks also might happen. So in order to cope up with that, these have to prevent the loss of water. So they are designed in a thick manner. The roots are bent deep into the soil for in search of water. The leaves are narrow, long, and it will grow in a condition that it needs a low rainfall and dry. Okay, in this situation, in this condition only, the particular plants such as grass will grow. Right, would you clear? So then plants in plains. So some of the plants are peepal tree, banyan tree, sesame tree, etc. So they have thick trunk and broad leaves. Okay, their root went deep into the soil, so it can absorb the water easily. In such a way, the peepal tree can adapt to live in plains. Right, and in polar region, since the condition is so cold, the plants grow here are very small. They are very short. Okay, the example for this is Arctic poppy. Then animal plants in water. Okay, these are called aquatic plants. They are categorized as floating plant, underwater plant, and fixed plant. Floating plant in sense they just float on the plant. They don't have any support under the water. Right? Underwater plant, it will see under the water. It won't see outside the water. We cannot see these plants outside the water. It will grow only under the water. Right? Next, fixed plant. It will be seen outside, but its stem will fixed under the soil. Okay, in this way the plant has been designed. So first, floating plant, it has a spongy stem. Okay, example for this is duckweed and water hyacinth. Okay, they are very light. Okay, in this way the floating plant will adapt. And underwater plants, they are tape grass and hydrilla. Their roots are fixed into a muddy soil. These have roots which will fixed into the muddy soil. These plants can be seen under the water. They have narrow leaves. Right, then fixed plants, the roots will be seen under the water, which will fixed to the bottom of the water bodies. Next, it has a floating leaf that will float on the water. Right, example for this fixed plant is lotus and water lily. Would you clear, children? So these are the topics we have discussed. Right, so note down your today's homework. Take your workbook, page number 29 and 30. In that 10th question, classify the organisms given below as terrestrial and aquatic. Okay, you have to classify which organism is a terrestrial organism and which organism is an aquatic organism. Right, write the names of the organisms which cannot be grouped in any of these categories in the space given below. And also you have to write the organisms that will not come under these two categories. Mention that those names under the box which has been given, where the space has been given. And the 11th question, imagine you are an Eskimo living in a polar region. How will your life be? Imagine that yourself be an Eskimo. You are living in a polar region where the snowfall is too high. Right, so how will you live your life there? You have to imagine and answer this question. And the final question is, you have to complete the MCQ portion. Right, so these are the homework which has to be finished by yourself and uploaded in Google Classroom app. Okay, we can see in next session. Till then, stay safe, stay connected. Bye.